The Voyager 1 space probe is the most distant man-made object from Earth. It has traveled so far that it isn't even in our solar system anymore. But even in the vast emptiness of space, Voyager 1 recently detected something truly astounding. You are watching Matter. In this video, we'll discuss the strange sounds that Voyager 1 heard emanating from deep space. On September 5th, 1977, a Titan IIIe rocket blasted from Cape Canaveral. The rocket's payload was a Voyager 1 spacecraft. 2 years later, in 1979, Voyager 1 flew past Jupiter, getting a boost in speed from the planet's incredible gravitational field. As it flew past, it captured new, high-resolution images of Jupiter and its strange moons. In 1980, Voyager 1 reached Saturn, the final destination of its primary mission. Voyager 1's trajectory around Saturn had been adjusted in order to perform a flyby of the moon Titan. This flyby pushed the spacecraft's trajectory below the south pole of Saturn, which in turn tossed Voyager up and out of the plane of the solar system. Its planetary science mission was over, since encounters with other planets would no longer be possible, but the gravitational slingshot maneuvers around Jupiter and Saturn put Voyager 1 onto an escape trajectory out of the solar system. In 2012, a full 35 years after its launch, Voyager 1 reached the edge of the Sun's sphere of influence, becoming the very first artificial object to have ever left the solar system and pass into interstellar space. Astonishingly, more than 4 decades after it left Earth, the Voyager 1 probe is still operational. It is still sending back data from the very furthest edges of explored space, at a rate of 16 bits per second. To compare, typical internet upload speeds today are at least 50 million times faster, but Voyager 1 is transmitting from more than 14 billion miles away and getting 325 million miles further every year. So, sending data across that much space is certainly not an easy task. For nearly the past decade, Voyager 1 has been traversing the cold, lonely wilderness beyond our solar system. But outer space, despite what the name might suggest, isn't entirely empty. Not quite. The interstellar medium, the stuff that exists in the space between stars, is made up of a very thin smattering of molecules and charged particles, an average of less than one particle per cubic centimeter. Just as the particles of air in our atmosphere carry vibrations that we hear as sound, the tenuous plasma of the interstellar medium can also carry vibrations, albeit much, much weaker. Voyager 1 has 2 30-foot antennae that stick out from one side of the spacecraft, which are part of an instrument called a plasma wave system. These antennae are the ears that Voyager uses to listen in on what's going on by measuring subtle variations in the tenuous plasma around the spacecraft. It turns out that in space, Voyager can actually hear something screaming. In 2012, Voyager heard its first sounds from interstellar space, a brief, relatively high-pitched whistle. A second whistle was heard around 6 months later. These interstellar noises correlate with sudden bursts of activity happening in the Sun, which creates rippling in the interstellar medium like rocks dropped in a pond. These shockwaves are useful because the frequency of the sounds can allow astronomers to estimate the density of the medium that Voyager is flying through. Stella Ocker, an astronomer at Cornell University, says that these screams from outer space have only been seen about once a year. So, relying on these kinds of fortuitous events meant that our map of the density of interstellar space was kind of sparse. So, while these periodic flares of sound from the Sun are helpful, they only offer a short glimpse into what is really going on. In order to get a complete idea of the nature of the interstellar medium, astronomers really need to know what is hiding between those bursts. To get a better picture, Ocker's team set out to fill those gaps. They use Voyager's plasma wave system to try and get a continuous measurement of the interstellar medium. Earlier this year, they finally succeeded. The Cornell team announced in May 2021 that Voyager 1 has heard a very faint, low-frequency hum coming from deep interstellar space. Ocker describes the signal as very faint and monotone. The sound may be faint, but it is consistent. Another team member, James Cords, describes it like a quiet or gentle rain. In the case of a solar outburst, it's like detecting a lightning burst in a thunderstorm, and then it's back to a gentle rain. This background noise vibrates around 3 kHz, but Ocker notes that over time, we do hear it change, but the way the frequency moves around tells us how the density is changing. This is really exciting because we are able to regularly sample the density over a very long stretch of space, the longest stretch of space that we have so far. This provides us with the most complete map of the density of the interstellar medium as seen by the Voyager. The new data show that the interstellar medium's density began to increase around 2013 and reached a peak near 2015. It seems to have mostly stabilized for now, with an electron density of around 0.1 particles per cubic centimeter. So what exactly is causing the vacuum of outer space to hum? The answer isn't exactly clear, but thanks to Voyager and the Cornell team, it's becoming a little clearer. They're calling this phenomenon plasma wave emission. The prevailing theory is that the continuous humming is caused by the vibration of the thermally excited particles themselves within the interstellar plasma. Hopefully, with continued observations of the interstellar medium, astronomers will be able to shed some more light on this odd noise. Voyager 1's nuclear power source has kept it alive for significantly longer than its original mission, but it's expected to only last for a few more years. Voyager might finally go silent as early as 2025. Stella Ocker said of Voyager, "Scientifically, this research is quite a feat. It's a testament to the amazing Voyager spacecraft. It's the engineering gift to science that keeps on giving." Already, Voyager 1 and its twin, Voyager 2, have given astronomers an invaluable amount of new scientific knowledge. And now the knowledge even extends beyond the reaches of our solar system. Up until now, astronomers have had to rely on the guesswork and computer simulations to figure out what the space around our star is like. But thanks to these newly discovered cosmic sounds, Voyager 1 can listen to how the interstellar medium is moving and changing in real time. As long as it continues to operate, that little probe will be able to offer even more fascinating insights into the nature of the unexplored cosmos. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel for more fascinating discoveries about our universe.